Meanwhile,
while mom does chores, she sits around
on her,
you know what,
donkey. Wanted to give you guys an update on our cow, Honey. Look at how much she has improved.
Yeah, if you go back to any videos in August or September, you would be able to see how skinny she was. She's gained 100 pounds, and she's gotten her winter coat.
Yeah.
And as you can see, she is a greedy little cow.
Yeah, but what happened, the whole picture, was she ended up... When we got her, she had worms worse than we thought. We had the vet out several times, and he just said, you got to keep worming her, and you got to keep feeding her, and we've been giving her all kinds of grains so she can bulk up, but we believe she's past her issues.
Yep, she's past her issues. She's looking really, really healthy.
And I am so happy because I was worried going into winter.
I was really worried about going into winter.
Because it's supposed to be 9 degrees tonight, and that's no joke.
Yeah, no.
Because it's hard on their bodies, too, because they the food that they eat then goes to trying to stay alive.
Yep.
And so, way to go, Honey. Way to go, Mom. Yay, God, thank you.
Yeah.
So, generally, the cows know their routines pretty well, but they're being stubborn today.
Hey, that's not your food.
They're being stubborn today.
Come on,
but... Another issue that we have when it's cold out is just simply touching things. Almost all this stuff is metal, and boy, oh boy, it really goes right through you.
Oh, I know what it is. Dottie doesn't like Honey.
Honey doesn't like Dottie, and Dottie doesn't like Honey.
Go on.
Yeah, they definitely have their personalities. Honey's the boss?
Honey's the boss, even though Dottie was here first.
Come on, girl.
Out you go.
She's doing good.
Out you go. Go
hey,
on.
But you know what? This might be a good opportunity to let people know who don't have a family milk cow or cows in general.
Right.
They're cold, hardy animals.
Right. Their hair has gotten 3 times as thick as it was in the summertime.
Yeah, it's pretty thick.
It's really thick. And when you see cows out in the field and you see a layer of snow on top of them,
that's okay. Yeah, they're not. It's not bad.
Because their hair is insulating their body. If it was melted...
Then that's the problem.
That's the problem, where then their hair is wet. But, hey.
She's pushing you.
Don't shut me out of the way.
Hey, you turkey.
Bad girl. No, no, no. You behave yourself.
Yeah.
You behave yourself.
You know, I saw something, too.
No, you don't.
I saw something, too, because there's a big push right now to the governments, the governments. Are trying to make a big push saying that, oh my gosh, cows, the ruminants in the cows are so bad because the methane and all that.
No.
And they're saying one of the indicators is how bad they smell. But our cows do not smell.
No, they don't have a smell because...
How they're treated.
How they're treated and what they eat.
Yep.
When they eat only, or not, I should say 98%
grains.
Grass.
Yeah.
Then their bodies do what's normal.
That's correct.
Yes.
What I was saying was flip flopped.
If they're eating, 100% corn silage, then yes,
they're gonna stink.
They're gonna smell. I know when we're driving past a feedlot that feeds silage, or even a dairy farm that feeds silage, you can smell the difference.
Yeah, even when these guys burp, it's like a yucky burp, but it's not like
a grassy yucky burp. Yeah, like fermented grass. That's all it is, because it's fermented grass.
That's what it is.
Why? You can love on me?
They're in good mood today. Puzzle. It's humiliating what she makes you do. No, it's not. Oh, little one in. No.
Yeah, little one's coming in.
Big one out. Little one in. You are one handsome devil. Can you do any tricks yet?
Like what?
I don't know.
Come on, Clover.
Do-si-do. Maybe a little line dancing. That'd be kind of cool. Line dancing with a donkey.
Come here, Clover.
And here's Clover. She's doing really good. Oh.
Oh, you're sweet. No, not you. Come on.
Look at you go. Look how she's doing really well, too.
Yeah.
And this one's how old now, Mom?
7 months.
7 months? But since we're doing a video on cow updates, I guess.
Yeah.
Woo! Hallelujah. This one, take a look at how her from the back end. Look at her sides. She's definitely pregnant for sure. But look at how the baby's definitely hanging over.
When she's like major pregnant, she barely fits in there.
Yeah, she's snug.
Yeah, but she's just a wide cow.
Yeah, but she is doing so good. She stood here. We had some trouble with the actual surge milker today, and it's because it froze up.
Yep.
And so, shut it off. There we go. That's better for the audio anyway. Mmm, nice. How you doing? So, it is a lot more difficult during the winter to do basic chores.
Yeah, basic chores in the winter time are a little harder because everything's really cold. And if you leave this out on a relatively warm day, you know, it's fine. But when it gets down into the 20s, if you don't get all of the fluid out of the tubes, it freezes.
That's what happened. There was just a little bit of water down in that little, in the vacuum tube.
And up here in the top was frozen right here too.
So,
any kind of blockage and it will not work.
Yep.
So.
Yeehaw.
All right,
okay, another thing that is a struggle when you're dealing with cows in the cold. Well, runny noses, is the water. Obviously, water freezes at 32 degrees. Well, it gets a lot colder than 32 degrees for several months here, and many places where animals are kept. Mm-hmm. So we have tried absolutely every scheme that you can think of to keep water not frozen. And to be honest, the only one that we've come up with in this kind of weather is electric heat.
Yeah, you have to use electric heat up here.
Yeah.
The salt water bottles in the water, that does not work.
Not here.
No. It gets to be 30 below zero as the normal temperature, and you can't, won't work.
Well, even 0 degrees over a course of a few days, everything is going to be a problem.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And so electric is the only way we've figured out how to do it. Yeah. I've tried solar. I've tried all kinds of stuff. And to be honest, they work for a little bit, and then they just don't.
Yeah.
You're going to have some kind of heater.
Right.
That is an issue for sure.
Yeah. So, yeah, we have a stock tank heater. In the stock tank out there, we have a heated hose going from our water spigot all the way out to there so that we're not having to haul water. We also have heat tape on that water line in there. And actually, I was noticing the handle stays warm.
Yes, it's a good heater.
Which I was worried about.
Yeah, it's a good heater. Yeah. And it was actually kind of a pain in the butt because I had to... Well, here, I'll just show you. I had to... let's see, will it flip around now? No, it won't flip around now. There. There was a sleeve that goes down in there, a PVC sleeve, and I had to kind of wrap it and push it down as it went down deeper in there because the sleeve was already there. But anyway, one other thing about the water is if you don't get your water warmed up, if you get it past frozen, that's okay. But if you can get it warmer, it's much better for the animal's digestion.
Yes. An animal who is struggling to put on weight or struggling to stay warm, if you feed them cold water,
it's hard.
It uses their body uses more energy to warm up that water or whatever to digest it than it would be if it was warmer.
That's right.
So it's better to have the water a little bit warmer, not hot, not even warm to us, but definitely
above 40.
Above 40, yeah.
Above 40.
Yeah. I wonder what the water feels like out here.
I don't know. Hey, hold on. Time out. We're going to finish the video.
Yeah, okay.
So, hey, that's it.
That's
I hope some of these tips have helped you because We had a learning curve.
We have had a learning curve. This is our fifth winter here in central Wisconsin, and we're still learning stuff.
Yeah.
So it's been fun.
That's it. I'm Brad.
I'm Krista.
You guys have an amazing and blessed day. Bye.